Dr. Duncan Robertson is from Loughborough University School of Business and Economics. Duncan, morning.
Morning, Ben.
Is that something that you would go along with, that a resurgence in hospital cases is likely?
Well, I think, it's all very difficult to predict, but when these sort of projections are made, there's a certain, interval or, variance, difference between what could happen at the low end and what could happen at the high end. And of course, we are still, we're not out of the woods, it hasn't gone away. There is still this, virus around. And so, some of those cases will lead to hospitalizations. And I think, that with more mixing, there will be more transmission of the virus, which will lead in some cases to hospitalizations. And of course, that's, if you like, the trade-off. All these things are trade-offs between opening up the economy, which we'd all like to do, and making the number of hospitalizations as manageable as possible.
Can you detect from the figures whether the number of people vaccinated is having an effect on sort of throttling back the virus's ability to transmit itself?
Well, I think there has been some data that transmission is reduced with vaccinations, and that's really good news. But of course, the problem with that is we have a whole group of people that haven't been vaccinated. So it may be that there's a sort of threshold of age, whereas older people are not transmitting the virus. But of course, people under 50 who haven't had the vaccination so far will be vulnerable to transmission. So they're the people who perhaps mix more and mix with more different people. And so you may see, transmission in that group. But of course, it's all to do with how much the society has opened up. So, that's can be controlled in a certain way.
It's interesting because I know you introduced us to heat maps six or 8 months ago or whatever it is, and essentially that just shows brilliantly, because the redder it is, the more cases there are, and you always said that the point is that younger people transmit it through, and you see this sort of red band extending into the higher age ranges. Presumably those heat maps, if what you say is the people vaccinated in the older age ranges, presumably it could go red and then blue very quickly once you get to, the over 60s or something.
Well, and to a certain extent, we're seeing that with the heat maps that I'm producing now. The older age groups, and that's actually everybody above 20, the rate's going down. But in the 10 to 19 year olds, these are people who've perhaps been at school, it's increasing. And what we potentially we'll see is that will increase further and go up the age groups in the weeks to come. But it's looking very positive for certainly the over 70s, the over 60s even. The rates are relatively low there, and what we hope is those rates will remain very low, because of course they're the people who are most susceptible to being hospitalised.
Are these figures sort of in line with best expectations?
I think it's gone pretty well. I mean, the vaccination has obviously been a tremendous success, and that's what we're reaping the rewards for. And of course, with all these things, the risk is that we see something going well and then decide to let our guard down and open everything a bit too quickly. So this is the real risk. And of course, pressure will come for people to say we need to open everything now, because rates amongst the most vulnerable are going down significantly. But certainly in this latest opening up, the data is good. I mean, it's very good. With the slight concern about number of variants, and you can see, there are the South Africa variant and this P1 Manaus variant, but there are cases here. And it was interesting actually listening to Chris Whitty yesterday. He was really saying that actually a lot of those are caught by at the border, essentially. So there are cases being detected. What we don't want is those variants to be you know, circulating wildly in the population, because then, of course, that introduces a high risk.
What is the, what, just to remind us, what is the risk of the variability? I heard a senior MP yesterday, it was on, I think it was Channel 4 News over the last couple of days anyway, but I saw it on social media yesterday, saying that the and I'm more or less quoting here, the variability argument, and he said, was biologically illiterate. What is the variability argument?
Well, I think it's really saying that some of these, the original virus mutates, and you know there are, and each of those mutations is either better or worse in some way. It might be better at, you know, transmitting, for example. And I think that what we find that is that some of these have a, you know, potential risk of what's called vaccine escape, which means that the vaccines aren't as good at these particular variants, because the vaccines will target a certain bit of the virus. And if it sort of changes in a way that sort of allows it not to be so effective, then, of course, that can mean that we still have some effect within the vaccinated population. But, of course, we hope that there will be some protection from having the vaccine for kind of all or most variants.
But this variability thing is essentially evolution. We're watching evolution happen, aren't we?
Well, I think that's right. I mean, you know, the virus is evolving, but it's not sort of evolving all at once. There are different kind of strains and different lineages, as they're called, which sort of all mutate and evolve at in different ways. And of course, the one that we're, you know, that certainly Europe is battling with at the moment is this B117, this Kent variant, which we, you know, suffered quite significantly from just before Christmas. And that's why, you know, essentially we had to go into that large, significant lockdown just after Christmas. And we're sort of hoping that won't happen again. But, you know, hopefully it won't. But of course, with all these things, there is a risk.
And it's interesting watching the telly. You're seeing more and more adverts along the lines of "Look, don't let your guard down." I suppose, and that sort of alludes to what you were saying a minute or two. It's very easy to see the figures and go, "Well, it's all right now. We're opening up. Let's go to the pub."
Well, yes, and exactly. Everybody would, you know, like to do the things that
can't
we've
wait myself.
You know, almost forgotten about. You know, how to have fun. But essentially, you know, there is this risk, and I think what is good about, you know, what's happening now is most of the things that are opening up are outside, and you know, I think there's a lot of evidence that transmission outside is a lot lower than transmission inside, and I think you know, and of course, it's much easier to do that when the sun's shining, the birds are singing, but the risk is, I think, when indoor venues open, there's potentially, you know, more risk of transmission there. So that's, if you like, the higher risk. So, you know, it's interesting talking about gyms opening. You know, if they're inside, then there's, you know, potentially higher risk. But, you know, with all these things, it's not as though there's high risk and low risk. You can always mitigate some of these risks. So, for example, ventilation, you know, keeping the windows open, keeping air going through is going to essentially, you know, mitigate some of that risk.
Duncan, thanks ever so much. It's interesting times, and thanks for keeping an eye on it. Just as a gut thing, obviously the worry is a further wave down the tracks. Are we likely to see a wave or a ripple or what?
I think we're going to see some excess, you know, hospitalizations and deaths, but because vaccines aren't 100% effective and not everybody has a vaccine. So I think we will see some of that. Hopefully that will be relatively low. But, you know, that's why we have to keep a real eye on these areas.
All right, Duncan, thanks. There you are, Dr. Duncan Robertson joining us here on BBC Radio Leicester, as he does pretty much every week, actually. He had a week off last week, but has been doing for over a year now. So massive thank you to him for keeping an eye on those figures and giving us an idea of where we are as far as the pandemic goes.